Welcome back to Linear Circuit Theory. In last lecture, we have discussed about Z parameter and the Y parameter. And in today's lecture, we will discuss about H parameter and the transmission parameter. So first, we are starting with the H parameter. So there are four variables, I1, V1 as input current and input voltage, and I2 and V2 representing output current and output voltage. So in H parameter, input current I1 and output voltage V2 is the independent variable, while input voltage and output current are the dependent variable. Or V1 and I2 is the function of I1 and V2, and can we relate this by the H parameter. So basic equation is V1 and I2 is function of I1 and V2, and parameter is H11, H12, H21 and H22, and this is I1 and V2. Okay. And if we make the equation of this parameter, that is V1 is H11 I1 plus H12 V2, and I2 equal to H21 I1 plus H22 V2. These are the two equations. So how can we find the parameter? First, make the V2 equal to 0. You can calculate the value of H11, H21, and second time make the I1 equal to 0, means input port open circuit, and calculate the value of H12 and H22. So H11 is defined as V1 upon I1 with V2 equal to 0, and H21 is defined as I2 upon I1 with V2 equal to 0. So what is H11? H11 is V1 upon I1, ratio of input voltage to input current. So this is an input port impedance with output port short circuit. So what is the difference between Z11 and H11? In Z11, that is also the V1 upon I1, but that is I2 equal to 0. So Z11 is represent the input port impedance with output port open circuit, while H11 represents the input port impedance with output port short circuit. So H11 is not equal to the Z11. And what is H21? H21 is ratio of current output to input current. So this is forward gain with output port short circuit. And for the value of H12 and H21, mean the I1 equal to 0. So H12 become V1 upon V2 with I1 equal to 0, and H22 is I2 upon V2 with I1 equal to 0. So see, what is H22? H22 is output current to output voltage with input port open circuit. Okay, so this is an output admittance with input port open circuit. While H12 is represented the transfer, inverse transfer voltage mode, because it is the ratio of input voltage to output voltage with input port open circuit. Okay, so these are my all parameter. If we want to draw the equivalent circuit of this H parameter, so this is representing the input current I1 and input voltage V1, and that is output current I2 and output voltage V2. So see, first equation, V1 is the sum of two terms. If V1 is the voltage, so these two terms is also the voltage. So I1 is the input port current, so it represents the impedance. So there is the first term is H11. So this is H11 I1. This term is also the voltage, but depending upon output voltage. So this is a voltage dependent voltage source. So here we have introduced a voltage source with value of H12V. And both are connected series because they are the voltage, and voltage will be added into the series form. So now if we apply the KVL in this loop, so this is V1 equal to H11I1 plus H12V2. So my first equation is satisfied. This is equation number one. Now for the equation second, I2 is the current. So these two terms is also the current. So there is two terms. Because I2 is the current, so these are the two term are the current, and current are connected to the parallel for the addition. So V2 is representing the voltage, so H22 is the admittance. So here we are representing H22. So first term is H22, V2 because H22 is the admittance. So current in this branch is H22, V2, and this term is also the current, but depending upon input current. So here we introduce a current source with value of H21I1, and this is a common point. So this represents the equivalent model of the H parameter. This parameter is very important. Why? Because it governs the mathematics of the transistor. Suppose here we are showing a transistor that is a common emitter configuration with input voltage VB and IB and output voltage VCE with common point. So in this transistor, input voltage representing VB and IB is the input current, output voltage VCE and output current is IC. So if you draw the input and output characteristics of the transistor, so see that in output characteristics is drawn between IC and VCE for the different value of IB. So see, this is IB1, IB2, IB3. So basically, as output characteristic is the function of input current, say if you draw the output characteristics that is drawn between IB and VBE as a function of different value of BC. So in transistor case, input current and output voltage are independent variable, and that is also defined by the H parameter. So H parameter represent the mathematics for the transistor. So therefore it is a very important parameter. Okay. So these are the mathematics related to the H parameter. Now we are discussing about the T parameter or transmission parameter. First, where we use the transmission parameter? As the name clear, transmission, we are transmitting the output. So suppose we have a number of device or amplifier, and if we want to pass on or transmit the output of first circuit to the input for the second circuit, so they are known as connect into the cascade. So transmission parameter govern the mathematics for connecting the device into the cascade, or output of first circuit per get the input for the second circuit. So see how can we govern the mathematics of transmission parameter. So now that is T parameter. So input current I1 and voltage is V1, and that is minus I2 and voltage V2. I2 current is represented inside, but because we have to transmit, so we have taken the negative sign and change the direction of the output current. So in transmission parameter, output voltage and output current are the independent variable, while V1 and I1 are the dependent variable. Okay, and the mathematics which govern this equation is the transmission parameter. So this is V1 I1 is transmission parameter is represented by ABCD. So this is ABCD and B2 and minus I2. And if we make the equation, B1 is AB2 minus BI2 and I1 equal to CB2 minus DI2. Okay. And if we make the relation between the parameter, okay, first make the I2 equal to 0 and second make the B2 equal to 0. So A is defined as B1 upon B2 where I2 equal to 0. C is defined as I1 upon B2 where I2 equal to 0. B is defined as B1 upon minus I2 with B2 equal to 0. And D is defined as I1 upon I2 with B2 equal to 0. So how can we find the parameter? One time you have made the output open circuit and second time you have to make the output voltage equal to 0. Then you can calculate the parameter. Can we draw the equivalent circuit of the parameter? Yes or no? So see, in Z parameter we have draw the equivalent circuit. In Y parameter we have draw the equivalent, same with the H parameter. But what is the difference between this transmission parameter and Z, Y and H parameter? In Z, Y and H parameter, independent variable has one related to the input port and one is related to the output port in Z, Y and H parameter. While here, both the parameter of the same port is independent and same port parameter is dependent. So when the parameter of same port is independent or dependent, we can never draw the equivalent circuit. Why? Because if you try to make the equivalent circuit, that B1, that is I1 current and voltage B1 and output current I2 and voltage B2. So see, this is AB2. So depending upon output voltage, so this is something AB2. This is minus BI2. Okay, so that is again dependent source with value of BI2. Okay. So because this is also dependent quantity and this is also dependent quantity, V1 is the voltage, so both are in series. But we cannot satisfy this equation at the same port because I1 should be in parallel and V1 should be series. So therefore, we cannot draw the equivalent circuit of the H parameter or T parameter. Clear? Okay. Now, we are discussing one more problem. On the H parameter or calculate the H parameter and the T parameter. Procedure remains same. Just if you want to calculate the H parameter, make V1 as a function of V2, V1, I1 and V2 and I2 as a function of V1 and I2. And make the relation and compare with your standard equation. So see, suppose question is saying find the H parameter of the circuit as shown in figure. So our objective is clear. We have to make relation V1 as a function of I1 and V2 means H11 I1 plus H12 I2 and I2 is the function of H21 I1 plus H22 V2. So we have to make the relation in such type of form. So see, first we are dividing the current. I1 is current in here, so I2 is the current in this branch. So you apply the KVL, this current is I1. I1 from here, I1 from here, so this current is 2I1. So see, this is not I1, that is an I2, okay. So because I2 is the current, so here current is 2I1. So current in this branch is I2 minus 2I1. Okay, I2 minus 2I1, I1 from here, so current in this branch is I2 minus I1. Okay, this is the current in this branch. Now, if we apply the KVL in this loop, so see, this is minus V1 plus 2I1 plus 2I2 minus I1 plus 2V2 equal to 0. Okay, so we have to make, this is not I2, that is V2. Okay, we have to make V1 as a function of I1 and V2. So just take V1 here, and this is 2I1, and there is term as minus 2I1. This will be cancelled out. So term is 2I2 plus 2V2, because this 2I1 will be cancelled out. So V1 is 2I2 plus 2V2, but we have to make I1 and V2, so we have to remove the value of I2. So this is supposed equation number one. Now we are applying the KVL in outer loop. So see, minus V1 plus 2I1. We are moving opposite to the current, so minus 4I2 minus 2I1, and this is minus 3I2 and plus V2 equal to Z. Okay, so what is the value? Minus V1, minus V1. This is 2I1 and this is plus 8I1. So now plus 8I1. Okay, so this term is clear. Minus 4I2 and this is minus 3, so minus 7I2. Okay, and this is plus V2 equal to 0. So now we check your equation. First we have to make the KVL in this loop. So this is minus V1 plus 2I1 plus 2I2 minus 2I1 plus 2V2 equal to 0. So this is V1, 2I1 will be cancelled. So this is 2I2 plus 2V2. So equation number one. And second, we have applied the KVL in outer loop. Minus V1 plus 2I1 minus 4, and this is I2 minus 2I1 minus 3I2 plus V2 equal to 0. So this is minus V1, 2I1, and there we get the plus 8I1. This is plus 2I1, and this term is plus 8I1. So there is term is 10I1. Okay, 2I1 and 8I1. And this is minus 4I2 and minus 3. So this is minus 7I2 and plus V2 equal to 0. So this is equation number second. So what the we have to make relation? First, we have to make V1 as a function of I1 and V2. Okay. So see, this equation is V1 is equal to 10I1 minus 7I2 plus V2. We have to remove the value of I2. So I2 can be calculated from here and put in this equation. So see, how can we make? So the value from here, I2 is V1 minus 2V2 upon 2. I2 is V1 minus 2V2 upon 2, and put the value of I2 in this equation. So V1 now become 10I1 minus 7I2. So now we are opening this equation. This is 7 by 2 V1 and 2V2 cancel out. So this is V2 and 7 terms. So this is minus minus plus 7V2 plus V2. So we have put the value of I2 in this equation, minus 7. So this is minus 7 by 2 V1 and this is minus minus plus 7V2 plus V2. So I1 and V2. So V1 is here. So this is 2 by 2 and 7 by 2. So now this equation becomes 9 by 2 V1. 9 by 2 V1 equal to 10 I1. 10 I1 plus 7 V2 of V2. So this is 8 V2. So V1 becomes equal to, divide this equation, 20 by 9 I1 plus this is 16 by 9 V2. Okay, now compare with your standard equation. So this H11 become 20 by 9 and H12 become 16 by 9. So this is my first two parameter. Now in second parameter, we have to make I2 as a function of I1 and B. Okay. In second equation, we have to make I2 as a function of I1 and B. So see, how can we make I1 and B? So see, this equation, I2 is a function of, this is my first equation, V1 and V2. So how can we calculate? So see, from this equation, I2 is a function of I1 and V2. So replace I2 equal to, this equation is V1 by 2 minus V2. So we have to replace V1. So V1 from this equation is equal to this term. Now put this value in this equation. So see, what is the value V1? We are putting the value of V1 in this equation. So I2 become, this is V1 by 2, so this is 5I1. V1 by 2, so 5I1 minus 7 by 2 I2 plus 1 by 2 V2 minus V. Okay, I2 and this is 7 by 2 is here, so that is again 9 by 2. I2 equal to 5I1 and that is minus 1 by 2 V2. So my final equation is, if we compare here, so see, I2 equal to, this is 10 by 9 I1 and this is minus 1 by 9 V. So I2 is, compare this from this equation. So this term is representing my S21 and this term is representing my S. Okay, therefore we can calculate all the S parameter of the equation. So calculation of parameter, just make the relation as what the standard equation has. Suppose you want to calculate the Z parameter, make V1 and V2 as a function of I1 and I2. In case of Y parameter, I1 and I2 is the function of V1, V2, same with T and H parameter. And compare with standard equation and calculate the all parameters. So very simple mathematics. But to care about how to make our relationship. Okay, just focus on KVL, KCL, nodal mesh. You can calculate all the parameters. Okay, today we will stop. And in next lecture, we will discuss about the connection of two port network as series connection, parallel, cascade connection, because these are important, because we have to collect a number of amplifier into the series connection, parallel connection, series, parallel series. Okay, so these govern the mathematics of the feedback amplifier. Okay, so in next lecture, we will start the connection of two. Okay, thank you.